As everybody knows, they were devastated.
Yeah, absolutely devastated. And, you know, the record books at this point record them at 0-14. You know, record-wise, of course, they're just fortunate that, you know, you don't need a winning or a percentage this year to get in the state tournament. And they're still a great team, and they still have some real good possibilities to put together a great season.
Yeah, that's a shame. A lot of problems. People are knocking a lot of people around. Blame can go almost anywhere, yeah, but to get away from the blame, the only thing I feel bad about, and I have to get off my chest because I mentioned on ESX, if the rumor is correct that there was one coach or two coaches in the Northeastern Conference who knew about this and knew about it before the season started and held it, and we're going to hold it until the end of the year, I think those people should be thrown out of coaching and put on an island someplace and not be allowed to associate with kids ever again. I hope it's not true, because I would hate to think that any coach in the Northeastern Conference would do anything to impact kids.
No, I certainly agree with everything you just said. I think it's important, though, that you know, we don't lose the focus as to what happened. You know, there was a rules violation. It was, you know, I mean, it's an age thing. The kid was overage. Salem lost the game. Simple as that. A rule's a rule. All the other baloney, I don't know what happened. I don't know who reported it. I don't know anything. I think it's incumbent on anybody in any program, when they become aware of a rules violation, to report it. And you do it immediately. You don't withhold that information until it's an advantageous time for your team or a disadvantageous time for the other team. You report it immediately, let the chips fall where they lie, and you continue on with the games.
The thing that bothers me, John, is I can't conceive of why anybody would benefit from waiting until the end of the season and turning people in.
Other than this petty jealousies whenever you have human beings around, and it's unfortunate, but they're those people become coaches sometimes.
And, I mentioned, too, like the Yankees and the Montreal Canadiens and the Celtics, people just don't like winners.
Yeah, and Salem's been a winner, that's for sure. But tonight we got a great game. We're playing at Lynn English.
English comes in with a record of 8-5. They've been a little up and down, John. They played some excellent games and played some quality clunkers in between.
Real up and down. And if there's going to be a game where Salem's going to be distracted and also at a disadvantage, it's going to be this one. They're playing the first game after having all the losses attributed to them, and they're playing here at English, which is always tough.
We'll see how they react. Salem has it first and the starting lineups. Saul Mateo was 22. Scooney Penn is 11. Tony Mataragas is 23. Wency Hernandez is 34. Tyson Witten is 21. Mateo for three. No good. He gets his own rebound. Brings it out. This is Mataragas and Scooney Penn. And they play a box and one. We've seen this many times from English.
Yeah.
Mateo again with the jump shot. Hits the swing.
And you said many times that Jason Schifini again is going to get the unenviable task of chasing around the best player from the other team. We saw him do it against Rogers of Swanskett, Johnson of Classical. Now we're going to see him do it against Scooney Pett. Ought to be interesting.
Juan Baca has the shot blocked.
That's an early message.
That really is.
Don't come in here, young man. Good quick hands by Penn.
Juan Baca is 30. Jesus Escalera is 45. Simi Anderson is 4. Jason Cipini is 23. Walter White is 41. The starting lineup for the Bulldogs. Cross court pass goes out of bounds.
Yeah, you saw him open on the other side and tried to throw that across the key pass. Very dangerous pass.
We've seen people use 1-3-1s against Scooney, but this is the first box we've seen.
Yeah, box and one. And again, Coach Garrity from Salem reacts by letting Scooney bring the ball up.
Mateo King hit the shot. Mataragas looking for the tap.
Yeah, very lucky Lynn English controlled that one. He didn't box out well at all.
Very lucky Quam Rocker almost double dribbled. Cipini for three. No good. Rebounded by Hernandez. Scooney Penn, 2-0, which is on top. Penn throws it up, no good. Rebound by
Anderson.
Gotta
give it up, he's wide open, John.
Yep, Cipini out ahead of the field, lays it in.
Nice drop.
Penn trying to get away from Cipini. Look for some screens up top. Find a release screen, we got a foul against Cipini, I believe.
23 is holding.
Yeah, you got him with a grab. When you're as good a player as Scooney Penn, the officials tend to watch what the other team's doing to you.
They should almost allow you to hold him a little bit.
No,
to even it off.
No, but what happens, John, after this rebound. After, what happens is the officials, they know who the players are, too.
Nice play by Scooney to knock the pass away. Mataragas comes up with it, and Tony pushes it up. Scooney for three. Around the rim and out.
Nice rebound by White that time, John. Escalera, I'm sorry.
Took it right away from here. It's Rocker for three. Too strong.
Wow.
Bounces. Whitten comes up with a basketball. Hernandez kicks it out to Penn, and he pushes it up. Hernandez with the jump shot. No good. Nice and Whitten with a big rebound. Blocked. Hernandez throws it up, no good. Escalera comes out with a loose basketball.
Okay.
And we're still tied at two.
Coach Bennett's calling out a set play. Let's see what's going to happen.
Jimmy Anderson for three. No good. Whitten with the rebound. Kicks it down court. This is Mateo.
Good defense.
Picked off by Walter White.
Nice hands by Cipini that time. He's wide open. Don't call a timeout now. We've got the deuce.
The same combination, Anderson to Cipini.
Right, but you see,
and it's 4-2.
Cipini's releasing, John. He's releasing. As long as English can get some rebounds, that shot's going to be there because Penn is so much involved in the offense for Salem that when he's playing the box and one on him, after the ball goes up, if English can control the defensive rebound, Cipini can get out on the floor.
Chase is going to make sure they get the ball up because if they kick it back to Scooney, he's going to be wide open.
Well,
somebody's going to say, whose man is that?
John, there's some things you have to give up when you want to try and beat a Salem team.
No, and, that's for sure.
You know, you need to make the easy baskets and, you know, to stay with them. The funny thing on that particular sequence, John, as soon as the ball got rebounded, you know, Cipini took off. Coach Bennett was calling for a timeout, and as it turned out. Luckily, the kids didn't hear him, and they ended up with a layup.
And it winds up with Salem. So they saved the timeout.
Yeah, right.
And they get a basket besides.
Yeah.
But yeah. This is the first time we talk about the pressures. They haven't really had a real pressure. They had one, I believe, at Classical, maybe. But where they were behind for a while, and they come back. Scooney made a couple steals at the end. Other than that, they've been pretty much in total command all the way. But this is a different type of pressure on them tonight. They're going to see if they can recoup.
I think it's more of a distraction than a pleasure joint. Pressure. I think what happens is you end up, you know, your mind's a funny thing. And your concentration level, if it's off one iota, you know, you're hitting the back rim and you're not getting the loose ball and you're doing all the little things, not doing all the little things that need to be done to win. Now, whether or not they can overcome that and play through it or not, we'll find out.
The strange thing, John, is that
nice steal.
Nice, great play by Walter White.
Nice steal.
What I said, John, was lots of times kids overcome these things easier than adults.
Sure. They do a lot less thinking about trivial things than we do. Oh, nice move there. They got Penn outside before
the drive. Nice move to the basket.
Nice strong move to the basket.
Jimmy has been really playing well for English, doing a lot of scoring. He's really been a big threat in the second half.
Six. Jimmy, get out of the way. Jimmy.
Jimmy, look at the way. Look, the play was meant to go for Jimmy Anderson.
Bad turn over there.
With the loose basketball.
Oh, nice play.
Gets it back, gives it off to Whitten, throws it up, no good. We got a foul underneath. Little slow motion stuff there. Tony, I think for a minute, didn't realize whether he could dribble a ball again or not.
Absolutely, but Cipini made the block in the initial. On the initial play, and again, his defensive pressure is as good as I've seen in the conference.
Oh, he's, you know, very often in high school, you'll see kids really play defense because they play 2-3 zones, 1-3-1, and they kind of get a little bit lazy. So, but all of a sudden, it's a case
now,
of
now there's some confusion.
Who the foul is?
They call the foul on.
They're trying to find who the foul is on.
Yeah.
They call the foul on Escalera.
I think it belonged on 41. Yeah. And Billy Lenehan, straightening it out.
Yeah, they straightened out its own Walter White. No, Walter White said he was on the other end, too.
Yeah, but that's not true. He was there.
Yeah, they're not going to get rid of both of them.
Huh?
Tyson throws it in.
Apparently, the official must have read the paper. He was a little distracted and lost his concentration.
Yeah.
Which happens sometimes.
Tyson is 2 for 2, and we're tied at 4. Rocker, covered by Scooney Penn, brings it up.
Almost 4 minutes to go in the game. 4 minutes gone in the game, John, and it's 4 points on each team.
Mateo almost made the save. He did make a great play, knocked it off Jimmy Anderson.
Yeah, knocked it right off his leg. Good hustle.
So the defense for the Witches coming up big.
Got to call out those picks. Jason Cipini's not making it through the evening.
So far, they're taking Penn.
Cipini's wide open again. They just didn't find him. They got to look.
Rucker going to the basket.
It went down. I guess that was the play.
Scooney Penn can't get it to fall. Escalera with the rebound. Looked like Rucker thought he was going to be fouled. I'll throw it until he get two shots.
Yeah. Well, here comes his shot.
Tip out of bounds off Hernandez. Jason puts it in play in the backcourt to Kwame Rocker. Looking for a play that possibly going to take it
away.
It
was there. He just couldn't handle the pass, John. Nice give and go.
To Scooney.
Oh, that's a charge. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
They call a block against Kwame Rocker.
It's on light
30
seconds back on the blocking.
See, I consider Billy the best official in the game. I really do.
Doesn't
but I don't agree with that one. That Angles player was standing there.
But Tyson Whitten back at the free throw line. Six to five. The Bulldogs are on top in the early going. We played just about 5 minutes, so very low scoring as Whitten makes it 4 for 4 and ties the game. Rucker going against Penn. Cipini inside.
Got him on the back.
Yeah,
nice play.
Hernandez. Good help defense by Hernandez, but he had to climb the back to get a hand on the ball.
Wow. See, Cipini made the nice entry pass, and it was there. It just...
But that kind of shows Michelle's reaction to the basketball. Everybody kind of, to help defense, that's why the defense has been so good for so many years. Cipini slows it down, brings it outside. Rucker looking to go against Whitten. They got a mismatch inside. Escalera's going to get called for pushing off.
A lot of banging going on in there.
Escalera had advantage inside. They were going to take advantage of the advantage. And he got caught pushing off. Penn.
Nice.
What a nice play. What a nice play by Tyson Whitten.
That's a nice play.
He's got 6 and 8. Salem is back on top, 8 to 6. Jimmy Anderson, the runner. Off the rim high, no good. Walter White with the rebound.
Nice rebound by
Cipini,
White.
Cipini, the outside shot for 2, no good. Whitten with it to Mataragas.
Again, great defense by Cipini.
Nice
finds the open man, John.
To Escalera for the stuff. The big turnaround. Scooney Penn can't get it to fall. Comes up with his own rebound. To Mateo for 3. No good. Escalera with the rebound. Salem stone cold.
Yeah, as is English, Sean. Yeah, nobody's
absolutely
making their outside shots. Holy mackerel.
Jimmy Anderson.
Oh, great rebound there.
Escalera. Tipped around, Mateo comes out with a loose basketball.
That's as aggressive as I've seen Escalera on the boards. That time he wanted the ball. Just missed putting it back in.
Penn, it's good for three.
That was the first time we saw a screen pick Chiappini off, and Scooney got an open jumper, and he'll nail that every time.
Yeah, this is the first time somebody did come up to help Jason when they had the pick.
No, don't dribble it too much.
Mataragas with the steal. Can't get the ball. Tipped up inside. Mateo comes out with a loose basketball.
Have a 3-second violation on Scooney. No, he got out of there just in time.
Jump shot, good. Salem on a 5-point run, keyed by the defense.
Oh, again.
Mateo again with the steal.
Now, when you're on the point.
Because he can't get the shot to fall. Rocca for three. It's good. The Witch is on top as Rocca ends that 5-point run. Penn for three. It's good! You knew they weren't going to keep him down for long. Chiappini covered by Mataragas now. Rocca going against Penn. Anderson. Loses it out of bounds.
He just got their awful weight. The play just never developed.
Oh, and plus they got totally congested in the corner. Four players with not much room. Offering sub, Jose Martinez in the game replacing Walter White. Rocker and Mataragas getting into a little bit of the floor, pushing and bumping, talking. See what happens there. Witten with the straighter jump shot, no good.
Oh, great inside position.
Big rebound inside by Tommy Giotti, who just came in the game. Ben Calixte is also in the game. So for Salem, it's Mataragas, Penn, Giotti, Witten, and Calixte. For English, it's Chiappini, Rocca, Escalera, Anderson, and Martinez. Tommy Giotti, the quarterback, at the line, shooting two. Gets the bounce. Tommy hits two. It's 11. That 7-point lead, 18-11, as Rocca goes to the basket and gets fouled.
Yeah, he definitely got fouled.
Nice, Tommy Giotti.
Yeah.
Well, they've always seen if you're going to foul him.
Oh,
make sure he knows it. And I think Juan knew it that time.
He knew it. Absolutely. That was one of those body slams, John.
Rocca at the line for the Bulldogs. Makes the first. Rocca. 2 for 2. Penn going against Chiappini. Calixte along the baseline. The jumper is short. Big rebound inside by Whitney. Lays it in.
Boy, I'll tell you, you know, Salem's just being real aggressive on the offensive board this the last few times down, and English just isn't keeping them off the boards.
Well, Whitney is really hanging on steady here, John. He's you know, he's improved probably 200%.
Yeah, and Giotti coming into the game just now really helped. Oh, nice rebound there.
Escalera throws it in.
And the Bulldogs come down, and they're aggressive on the board down this side.
Sam looked like a little full-court pressure that time. Mataragas fixed the shot to Scooney in the corner. Back out to Tony. Whitten from just outside the foul line hits the jumper. He's got 10.
Oh, steal.
Penn great lays steal. It in.
Just real quick hands.
Scooney's got 10. And it's a 9-point advantage for Salem. And English wants to talk about as they're down 24-15. And we picked up the pace a little bit, John. It was for the first 5 or 6 minutes, it was like 4-2.
Yeah, picked up the pace a little bit, and Salem stretching out to a lead here. You know, it's just, you know, we've watched Salem play so many times, John, and it's like all of a sudden it's a close game, and guess what? 2 minutes go by, and it's, you know, it's an 8-9 point lead. And,
kind of blink your eye, that defense and
absolutely.
Sort of run together.
And... Absolutely, and I think, you know, good timeout by English. Talk about it a little bit, see how they're going to deal with the pressure. They didn't deal with it real well the first time they threw it at him, Penn with the quick steal and the layup. And, you know, Coach Bennett, you know, working them a little bit. And...
Well, yeah, also, too, it's they got a break early. This would have been their second time out. They tried to call one before. Luckily, they didn't use it because you want to try and save some of those in case you need them late in the game.
Yeah, well, but, you know, you certainly love to have all your timeouts left, but you also, I think, as a coach, you have to utilize the timeouts to control a lot of the tempo of the game.
Well, and this was
a good timeout.
This was an excellent timeout. It's
absolutely.
Just that they saved the first one because Salem called them. The kids didn't see him. They'll throw down a Cicchini, lay it in, and they didn't have to use it. So,
absolutely.
That was a big break for English there. English inbounds it. Quam Rocker is the quarterback. He'll bring it up, the point guard. Jimmy Anderson looking inside.
Oh, that's
off.
A foul.
What a, oh, boy. Tommy Giotti picked off the pass. Penn drives, throws the runner. No good. Escalera with an authority rebound. Penn took it away, but got a piece of him.
Boy. You see? The ball. Good quick hands. That's his second foul, I think, John.
Escalera just went over and shook hands. But Scooty just got it together. And...
Oh, yeah.
Rucker. It is the switch. Rucker now covered by Calixte. Trying to get the shot up.
Pretty close to a 5 second count.
Yeah, got swallowed up.
Yeah.
Escalera from the top of the circle. Anderson with the long 3-point bomb. It's good.
Bang.
His first basket is a big one. Maragas outside. Witten back to Tony for the 3-point shot. No good. Collects, chases it down. Witten. Looking inside. Anderson with a nice play. Taken away. Witten. They get it out to Penn. Maragas fakes the shot. Drives the lane. Throws it up. It's good. Anderson from the corner for three. No good. Tipped around off the backboard. Maragas comes out with a basketball. 1-on-2. To Tommy Doyle. Jump ball as Calixte and Rucker are both on the floor.
I think nothing against Tommy Giotti, but I think Salem wish it was Tommy Doyle still. But
That's true. Tommy Giotti. A voice from the past. Maybe we've done too many shows.
Yeah, you aren't kidding. No, I don't think so. I certainly enjoyed every one I've done.
Oh, that's for sure.
Boy, I'll tell you.
The defense is tough.
It is tough, but you can't get caught in the corner and let them double up on you with the ball without after you've already given up your dribble.
Absolutely.
Swing the ball. Nobody there to swing it to.
Martinez winds up with it in the lane. Dumps it to Escalera. This is Rocker for three. He has it partially blocked by Penn, picked off by Witten. The foul is going to be on Martinez. 43. Curtis Anderson is in the ball game for English.
Cipini just came back in too, John. They didn't leave him out too long.
No, that's for sure. No. Brian LaMontagne is in for the Witches.
But it looks like they're going to let Curtis Anderson chase Scooney for a while and give Jason a bit of a rest.
Sean Mateo. Pass too far ahead, looking for Witten, gets out of bounds, and it'll be the Bulldogs' ball.
Good defense by English that time. They doubled up on the ball. Now we're seeing the pressure again. Let's see what happens.
Jimmy Anderson ahead to Curtis Anderson.
Good hustle by Witten.
Good defense by Tyson Witten.
Yeah. The big guy, Escalera, was wide open on the box, and it just couldn't get it there. That half
good
a step.
Good idea by Curtis Anderson, too. Hit the man
it
wide
was
open.
There, but it's just a hair too late.
Off look like an Australian pen, but
yeah, I'm not gonna officiate anymore tonight.
No, I'm not either.
I like Billy too much.
I'm not either.
Even though Billy didn't call that one.
Scooney Penn now, as John mentioned, being chased by Curtis Sands, so they switch off a little bit. This is Mateo. No good.
Oh, LaMontagne knocked out of bounds by LaMontagne.
Yeah, good recovery that time by Martinez. I mean, the weak side was left wide open by English, and he got back on the play to cause the Salem play to kick it out of bounds.
Mateo one-on-one against Curtis Anderson. Curtis almost lost it. Now it's tipped around. Stolen. Then out in front. Lays it in. You expose the ball, they're going to get it.
Oh, yeah. You just can't dribble by him.
And there's the help defense again. They almost lost it again. Cipini for three. Around the rim and out. LaMontagne comes down with the rebound, and Penn pushes it up. 28 to 18 inside. Knocked out. Escalera is going to pick up the foul.
All right. I think he might have got Martinez, John.
In the white. 43.
They did. You're right, John. It was 43.
Well, the reason I knew that was the look on Martinez's face. He looked as if, you know. So
he looks even worse. They just took him out of the game.
Yeah. Wow.
He liked it when he was on the floor. No player likes to be taken out for any reason.
Wow. One of the toughest things a coach has to do, especially at this level, John, is to get the kids the playing time they deserve. They all work hard in practice.
Boy, I guess so.
And it's difficult.
Winton hits the first.
So Tyson will get another one.
Can't get that one to fall.
Nice.
Giotti kept
rebound.
It alive. Mateo,
yeah,
off the pen for three. No good, too strong. Rebounded by Winton, he lays it in.
English has got to get somebody inside, put some bodies on some people.
Well, I'll tell you, when Salem has Giotti and Winton on the floor at the same time, they're tough
inside.
They're
big strong, absolutely, John. And all of a sudden, it's a 31-18 lead for Salem.
Anderson almost lost it. Gets it back, almost picked
foul,
off.
Yeah.
Penn answers
that's three,
it, I think.
Yeah, ooh, that's a big foul, John. With 2:59 to go, I wonder, Matarajas is coming in. And, I wonder if Matarajas was sitting there waiting to come in for him anyways. And then he picks up the foul, because he was already at the scorer's table before the foul was committed.
Well, that good, strong defense.
LaMontagne knocks it away. Anderson
loses
dribble,
it, gets it back. They finally call it. They are a little late calling it, but they got it.
Yeah, well, that doesn't happen at this level. You don't expect to see it, John. Hmm.
Donovan Billings will replace Tyson Winton.
Yeah, Winton played a nice first half, John. Now let's see what they do. They've been playing a boxing one all night. What are they going to go to?
English goes look like
1-2-2
or 3-2.
Yeah.
Mateo. Outside to LaMontagne. Might want to see Matarajas at the corner here with a shot, because he would probably be the shooter now in the game. LaMontagne fakes the shot. Now he throws it up. And in!
Nice
Boom.
Shot. Yeah. Nice touch.
A 15-point advantage for the Witches. Curtis Anderson for three, off the rim, no good. Jimmy Anderson throws it up, off the rim, no good. Donovan Billings, I believe, is going to get called for the foul. And we're going to have a timeout by the Bulldogs as it's starting to get away from them, Jordan.
Yeah, they're just, they're stuck on 18 and they just can't seem to score a basket.
Rocker is coming back.
Yeah. And you can't have a long drought against the Salem team offensively, because if you do, all of a sudden they're just too far out in front of you, and
you're looking
awful tough to make up.
If you're going to make a run and get back in the ball game, I would think that this would be an opportune time, even though there's only 2:08 left. You've got Scooney Penn and Tyson Witten both out of the ball game, and the rest of the team has only scored 8 of the 33. They've got 25 of the 33 points.
Well, I think
you would think at least defensively, you should be able to shut them down, possibly, and maybe
get a few points.
Well,
I think you try to force the game, John. I think as soon as Penn goes out, and Witten for that matter, but Penn especially, you pick them up all over the floor, full court pressure, trying to increase the tempo of the game. And, you know, if you can score 6 or 8 quick points, you can get back in the ball game before the half ends.
The amazing thing is some people are afraid to, even with Penn in the game, are afraid to just try it. You know, you get down by 15.
You get down by 15, you have nothing to lose.
But if there's a team that can probably stay with Salem speed-wise, it would be this English team with Jimmy Anderson and Curtis Anderson and Guam Rocker.
Definitely. I mean, what they did in Swampscott, John, when they went with a small, quick team, was as impressive as I've seen in a long time during that 5 minutes of...
Nice play.
Well, they should pick right up, you know? And, you know, they don't. They went to... There they go. Okay, they are picking up.
So Mateo gets shut up. Now he takes the jump shot. Can't hit it. We got a foul.
Oh.
It's going to be against Salem.
You see, now that's a bad foul, John. You're up in the ball game by 13 points with a minute and 40 to go here in the first half. You just don't want to pick up a foul like that.
Oh, English gets a chance to cut it down with the clock not running. 1:40 left. A big opportunity for the Bulldogs here with, as we mentioned, Schooner, Penn, and Tyson Witten both on the bench. I know realistically they like to probably try and get under double digits.
Yeah.
Shot is missed. Giotti loses it. Mataragas picks it up.
Yeah.
Tony drives the lane, throws it up and in. It counts and he'll go to the free throw line.
And I was just going to say they should be looking to take some air out of the ball and take some time off the clock. And Mataragas just brings it all the way up the floor, breaks into the middle, gets hit, makes the shot, and it's going to the line for the completion of the 3-point.
Shows you what we know.
Yeah.
But Tony is having, he has an advantage, I think, because there aren't many left-handers. And when you play defense, you're so used to the people shooting with their right hand that he has an opportunity to throw it up. And you're kind of shocked when you see it, that he throws it up with the left hand. Missed. Amonte knocks it loose. Scramble for the ball. It'll be English's basketball. With 1:29 showing on the clock, a 15-point advantage. 35-20. As Salem goes full court pressure. Mataragas covering Anderson.
Absolutely. You want to make it take as much time off the clock as they can, bringing the ball up.
And Curtis almost lost the basketball again. Juan Rocca. Long 3-point form is good.
Well, that they certainly need, but now they got to pick up and try and get a turnover.
And I agree with you, John. This would be an opportune time for Salem to just run some time off the clock.
Wow. Instead, they make a three.
Fernando's closing a three.
That's how much you know. I totally agree with you, but
we should never try to analyze this game again because have we ever been right?
No, very, very seldom. Nice rebound.
Ahead, picked off by Curtis Anderson. Throws up the three, no good. Billings gives it to Giotti, to Hernandez. Hernandez loses it. Anderson down court to Escalera. Tarraca back to Escalera. It's good.
Boy, he took him down hard, too. Both boys went down pretty hard that time.
Back and forth we go. Action at both ends that time. It is. Just lost it. And again, English finds the open man down floor and gets the easy basket. And Escalera will try to pick up the conventional three-point play. 27 seconds left. He can cut the lead to 12. Escalera with 8 here in the first half. Looking to complete the 3-point play. Bounces around, doesn't get it. Hernandez knocks it around. Jimmy Anderson gets it back. Rocca. The fall away by Rocca. In and out. Rebounded by Tyson Witten, who just came back. Picked off by Curtis Anderson. To Jimmy Anderson.
No travel, they got away with it.
Throws up the three, no good. Rebound by Mataragas. The foul.
Yeah.
And that hurts with 7 seconds left.
Sure does. But, you know, Mataragas would have had a 2-on-1 if he got by him. So, depends whether or not he makes the free throws, whether or not it was a good foul or not.
It's 2-1 Walter White with 7 seconds left. Simi opted for that 3-point shot. 13 points. Tony can get it back up to 15 if he hits both ends. Got to hit the first to get the second. Tony has 5 and the lead is 14. Makes them both. Curtis Anderson looking down court to Walter White. Picked off by LaMontagne, the buzzer sounds. John, 40 points in the first half, when in the first 5 minutes they had like 2 or 4, it was not bad.
No, like we said, don't blink your eyes.
That's for sure. 40-25, the Witches on top at halftime. We'll be back with second half action. Welcome back to English High School. John Hoff along with John Henry as we're about to start the second half with Salem on top 40-25 and fast pace considering we get off very slowly. They kind of picked it up towards the end of the first half.
Yeah, just a lot of scoring by Salem in the latter stages of the second of the first half, and they pulled out to a big lead here. We'll see how English responds after going to the locker room.
And
big
defense.
Thing to watch though is Cooney Penn with 3 fouls, John.
Whitten with a couple of fakes. How is it in? He's got 15.
Yeah, he's had a fine game. And that time Escalera got a piece of the ball. He still got it up, threw him in the basket.
This is Quam Rocker. He was the leading English scorer with 10 in the first half. Jason Rapini, straight man-to-man, looks like, by Escalero. Fadeaway. Witten with a big rebound. Penn, 2-on-1. Rapini back. The bounce pass to Matarajas.
Oh,
back
nice
to Penn.
Play.
He lays it in. Very unselfish basketball.
Yeah, the ball went to the wide open man, though.
Most guys, after the pass from Penn, would have taken the shot. In the first half, Penn had 12. LaMontagne had 2, Witten 13, Mateo 2, Matarajas 6, Hernandez 3, and Giotti 2. For English, Anderson, Simi had 3, Rapini 4, Escalera 8, and Rocker, we told you, was the leading scorer with 10 for their 25. Walter White, nice play by Hernandez. 3-on-1 this time. Penn to Saul Mateo. Can't hit it.
And Witten hustles
good
down the floor.
Hustled by Witten.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you got a 3-on-1, you're not even part of the 3, and you get the rebound and put it back in. That's hustle.
And all of a sudden, the lead balloons to 21. And
yeah.
All the fans that came to see whether Salem would overcome their problems and play some basketball.
No, they're a
might
great
have
team.
Had some questions in the first couple of minutes, but they've been wiped away now.
Absolutely. They're a fine team, John. And, you know, we wondered before the ball game whether or not they'd be distracted enough to lose some of the concentration.
Yeah,
but they really haven't.
Yeah,
other than the first 4 or 5 minutes.
Yeah, that's the reason we brought it up, because they were very slow coming out of the blocks, and Penn didn't get into the flow of things, and then all of a sudden Witten and Penn exploded, and that's what happens with the Salem team. The defense, it's almost like we said this is the sixth year now with all these championships.
Yep.
We say, when is the defense going to kick in? When is that run going to come? Because the defense usually
and it does.
Gets it going.
It absolutely does every time, unless the opposition has an answer to that. You know, you're not going to beat a Salem team, and that's why they haven't lost very many games in the 6 years that we've been watching them.
Well, obviously, they only lost realistically on the floor. They lost one game this year. That would give them something in the realm of 100 wins and only 5 losses in the last 5-plus years.
That's an amazing record.
No, 5 losses in 5-plus years is unbelievable. Rapini, and they really get clogged up, John, as you talked about before.
Yeah.
Anderson has it knocked away, gets it back. throws it up, no good. Big rebound by White, blocked
big
inside.
Block by Hernandez.
Witten with it, pushes it out to Mataragas. Mateo to Penn. Mataragas for three, no good.
Yeah, got him on the back.
Yeah, Hernandez.
Yeah, Hernandez was just a little too aggressive that time. He really didn't have the opportunity to get the rebound, but you really can't complain.
No, those are the kind of fouls you really don't mind, the aggressive fouls.
Wow.
You're a step away from getting inside position.
See him, watch for Simi Anderson to pick up a push-off call here pretty soon on the inbound, and he's just reaching up and pushing off.
And they are really playing tough. Man-to-man defense, almost a steal. Out of bounds, off Rockar, and Mateo and Penn combine again.
They just can't handle that pressure. They gotta find a way to.
They're so quick with the quick hands, the quick feet, and they really burn them. Mataragas. Inside to Whitten, the turnaround. Bounces, won't go, Hernandez gets a tap at it. Rebound Hernandez, fakes once and lays it in.
Yeah, and Salem's got everything going for him now. They're rebounding, their defense.
Inglis has yet to score off Salem. And it's an 8-0 run right now by the Witches. We played almost 2.5 minutes. Martinez throws it up off the glass and in.
Nice post-up move that time, John.
That breaks the streak. The 8-0 run by the Witches. Penn throws it up off the rim, no good. Off Escalari, chases it down. And Rocca will bring it up. Cipini looking inside to Escalera.
Nice pass.
Underneath to Anderson. What a move by Anderson. Martinez throws it in and the foul. That's the first real good piece of work they've done off the offensive glass, John, a long time. Simi with a nice move, Martinez with another nice rebound.
Right, but the whole thing was started up top of the key. They worked it, you know, off the top with Escalera getting the ball high, and then he kicked it down low, and I think that's what you have to look for against a real aggressive defense, John. As soon as the ball came high to Escalera, you know, he was attacked by three people. Give it up quick and get it down low.
This is Penn. Cipini covering him.
Big pick.
The pick again. Bounce. Mataragas drives the lane, lays it in.
Yeah, that's just too easy. That shouldn't happen.
Well, they're so concentrating on Penn outside coming up to help on the picks that Mataragas got wide open. Rocca throws it. Block knocked out of bounds by Martinez. Rocca thinks he could hit in the arm. And no call, it'll be the Witches basketball. Mataragas stops. Won't get the shot to go, but he's going to pick up the foul. Simi Anderson will pick up the foul. 50-29. Salem has really, since about the 6 or 8 minute mark of the first half, has really put it to the metal.
Yeah, this is as strong a period of time as I've, 8 or 10 minute stretch from the first half to the second here that they played as good as I've seen them play all year, John.
Yeah, they had to go both ways, shooting the ball, moving the basketball, and playing the defense.
Yeah, everything.
Picked
right
off
there,
by
another
Tyson
steal.
Witten. Pass tipped away by Simi to stop the cinch play. Big play by Anderson as he blocks the shot. Right to Scooty Penn. Mataragas throws it up, no good. Escalera with the big rebound. Good job by English on the defensive end that time. This is Martinez. Cipini covered by Mataragas. Mataragas knocks it away. Cipini gets it back to Anderson, to Escalera. The fall away is good. He's got double figures. Simi with the steal. Cipini with the basketball. Nice move by Jason Cipini.
Got you, showed him the ball, took it back and put it in. Nice play.
He can play for my team anytime.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
This is Mataragas, covered by Anderson. See, I'm going to set plays now. Trying to run something here. Maybe a little game with Penn and Mataragas. Quincy Hernandez will put it in play. Anderson almost took it away from Mataragas. Jump ball, English gets the basketball. Simi doing a job on defense.
Absolutely. Just step up and be aggressive at this point in the ball game when you're down by 19 points or, yeah, 19 points. You have to be aggressive.
Cipini, Escalera knocked away by Tyson Witten. Penn. Nice bounce pass to Mataragas. So Witten. Nice move. The foul's going to be against Martinez.
They had all kinds of pitchers under the basket. That time, Lindsey Hughes was all by himself. Yeah.
Witten, the leading scorer in the ballgame, will be at the free throw line. Witten hits one. As we get a visit by Bill Hall walking by on the floor. Tyson hits two.
I think it's interesting, John. I think how many games has Penn had 27 or more, or whatever number you were talking about the last time?
It's like, I believe it's six.
Yeah, and with only 14 here, with 10, almost 11 minutes to go in the game, I'd be interested to see if he gets it tonight or not.
Mataragas throws it up and in.
Not that it really matters, you know, with as many points as Salem has scored.
Rucker along the baseline, gets loose and throws it in.
Yeah, that's a nice drive. And again, what I think, you know, any team should be doing is take the ball inside as often as you can.
Well, you look at a lot of young players out here, John. Penn, yeah. Saul Mateo, our only sophomores. The shot went in, a great drive by Penn, but it's not going to count.
Yeah, he's got Martinez again outside.
You've got Rocker is only a sophomore. Escalera is only a junior. They're going to be back. A lot of nice players.
Yeah, no question about it.
Martinez is fouled out.
And we're going to see McManus.
Mike McManus for the first time.
Yeah.
Mike was a starter.
And played some pretty effective minutes. Yeah.
Played well.
Yeah.
So it's McManus, Cipini, as Hernandez gets loose and throws the left hander.
Nice inbounds play, John. Just a real nice inbounds play. Anytime you run that inbounds play and you end up with a layup, that's just absolutely good coaching.
Doubling up on Cipini, he lost it. Now we're going to pick up a foul. Tony Smith himself hits himself in the head.
Yeah. Hit himself in the head and said, stupid foul. Exactly.
Mataragas, Mateo, Penn, Hernandez, and Witten out there for Salem. It's Cipini, Simi Anderson, Tom Rocca, Escalera, and McManus for the Bulldogs. As Rocca gets swallowed up, McManus has it knocked away. Witten comes up with a loose basketball, and Scooney Penn pushes it up. The three by Penn. No good. Rebound by Escalera. The touchdown pass to Rocca. Goes to the basket. Throws it up. No good. Cipini with the follow.
Good hustle by Cipini. And those words go together anyway.
Oh, that's for sure. Yeah. Again, you see the touchdown to Rocca. Most people say, I'll stand back and play defense.
Yeah.
Quick steal there. Simi Anderson with the basketball. Combining with Rocca. Rocca winds up with the basketball, throws the shot. Hernandez with the loose basketball.
Wow.
A little faster pace right now. Yeah. Mataragas, great pass by Penn.
Yeah, we're in garbage time early, John, with the start is still out there. That's
sure.
What this is.
That's for sure. 60-39. Rocca gets loose. It's no good. He's going to go to the line for three, I believe.
In the red, 22. gets him in the three-point area, we're going
to
shoot
free. That call you don't see very often as Brian LaMontagne and Ben Cunningstein comes in. Rucker at the line shooting three.
Three.
Rucker is the only player for the English team that's, that has made a foul shot.
Really?
Yep, he made two in the first half, and that's the first one they've only made three.
I think, and you know, they don't go to the line that often, John, and I think that that directly relates to the fact that they don't take the ball with the basket as often as they should.
They don't use Escalera as much as
he's the player, too.
Yeah, he certainly is.
But again, it's easy to say.
Sure.
But, holy mackerel, we got a whole bunch of young men waiting to go in a game here.
I think somebody heard you say garbage time.
Yeah, I know it. Salem made two subs, and now here comes four for English on the next dead ball.
LaMontagne can't hit the shot. McManus with the rebound. Rucker will push it up. Rucker looking to get loose. Goes to the basket, throws it up off the glass and in. He's got 18. 60-43. Penn drives the lane, throws it up, no good. The foul will be. Well, they actually call a timeout.
Yeah.
For English, it's Walter White, Mario Carrero, Chris Puska, all coming in the basketball game, along with Curtis Anderson. We'll see who stays in the game for it. Looks like Mike McManus is going to stay in the game.
Well.
So virtually a brand new five for Lynn English. Certainly a bench five.
Yeah, but that's what happens when you're down by 17 points with 8:30 to go. You kind of, you know, reaching for straws and trying to get different combinations in the game, see if something crazy can happen. But
the amazing thing too, John, is this is the place at English where people used to not like to come because
it was always
tough to play. And it seemed as though English was always playing tough here.
Well, you got a small gym. You always got a big, boisterous crowd. You know, you're in tight quarters. English, you know, historically always played tough here. You know, but you know, as the song says, times are changing.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Yeah, and the official Bill Linehan, because there's more than three replacements at once, Salem can, you know, ask for a lineup so they can look who their defensive man will be.
So they get that straightened out. Salem has the ball, he'll be taking the ball out of bounds. 8:30 left to play in the basketball game. The inbounds
pass. Nice inbounds play. It was there. Was there again, John, only he fumbled the pass.
Hernandez couldn't get the shot off.
Nice steal.
Nice play by LaMontagne. The half hook shot by Whitten is good.
Boy, and you see that time, I got it the other way. You know, Whitten had the elbow out and gave the little push. You know, that's an offensive foul that never gets called, but it was. You know, Walter White went straight up. Whitten came out with the left hand and kind of shielded him. And that's an offensive foul. Never called, but it is.
I think you get away with that because the shot was a little bit of a hook shot moved, and the official was probably watching his sweeping arm take the shot rather than the other arm pushing out. Eight for nine from the free throw line.
Be interesting to see how this five moves the ball for English, whether or not they do anything different.
Loose on the floor. Ben takes it away.
Is he quick, huh?
I guess he is.
Bye.
What a shot
highlight
by Scoobie Ben.
Wow.
He gets that one step and see you later.
I tell you, that even makes you appreciate the job Jason Cioppini did on him in the first 24 minutes of this ball game.
No question. He only hit 12 in the first half, but a couple of those three-point bombs were when Jason got picked off and nobody came up to help out. So Jason did an excellent job on what I remember Donnie Boylan's radio program said tonight, perhaps the best player in the Northeast Conference.
As a sophomore.
And it was Billy Kaporos. As Ben Kalich steals, goes in and lays it in. Billy Kaporos.
Mulhara and myself said, perhaps.
Perhaps.
Is there a question mark there? Curtis Anderson.
And gonna
can't
shoot
get
three.
The fall. He's gonna get three shots. Kalixte will pick up the foul. Didn't see it very often. We've seen it twice in the last minute.
Oh, when you're a three-point team, I guess you see that. But as you say, unusual.
Congratulations also to Buzzy Barton, who won the pot of gold here tonight.
Is that who won the pot of gold?
They couldn't find anybody, and well, Mr. Burke came up and checked his tickets and said, the guy in front of me must have won it. And then he said, wait a minute, the guy in front of me was Buzzy Barton. And Buzzy was outside or something, didn't know it.
Absolutely fantastic. That's great. I was talking to Buzz before the game, just a good friend.
Well, he's a great guy.
Great guy.
You know, does a lot for the kids and everybody else here at English and helps out.
I remember sitting in this gym watching him play, John. Oh, that's a travel.
I do, too.
Yeah, I mean, and he played pretty darn well.
One of the better players in this play here at English. That's why I wish somebody would take the bull by the hands and say, let's start a Hall of Fame here at Plain English. They've done it everywhere else. So they can bring some of these real good players and give them some recognition again that they deserve.
Well, being an English High alum, I'd love to see it happen.
Mario Carrero with a nice drive.
No game Tuesday night.
Then inside to Whitten. Makes the move to the basket.
Oh, that's a strong move.
Walter White got a piece of him. That's four on Walter White.
Yeah, and that was more of a frustration foul than anything. Whitten beat him clean, and then he just came back in, reached, practically tackled him to keep him from making the basket.
Well, normally if you drop it in, the guard's going to drop down and help you out. Well, you couldn't in that instance because the man will be exposed to Scooney Penn. You don't want to give him the three opportunity, so they stayed with Scooney, and that left Tyson Whitten one-on-one.
Well, again, you have a player of Scooney's ability, and it just dictates in how you play defense, you know, as a team. It's difficult.
It just shows you there's an instance where he doesn't have the ball, he's not involved in a play, and he still affects what happens on the floor.
Absolutely, and there's so very few players like him that it's tough to train your defense because you don't get the opportunity to play against somebody as talented that often.
The foul is going to be against Brian LaMontagne.
In the red, 2-0.
But it's still... But I'm still just totally impressed with the overall defensive effort of the Salem Ball Club. You know, we've been saying it for so long, and you know, it's just that you do out of habit, and you develop those habits at an early age in a good program, and that's where these kids have grown from.
And it's been the program under Jack O'Brien, now under Paul Garrity, and different kids, different players,
but it goes back
to the intensity is the same.
Absolutely, but it goes back to when they're 10, 11, 12 years old, and they're playing. You know, they've got a great program, and it's...
Ben Kalixte with a nice move is going to go to the foul line. Yeah, I think everybody would like to have this last 6:37 be over.
And anybody that's been to the Lynn English High gym knows when you're sitting in the bleachers, you're all the way on. You have to go across the floor to get out the door. It's a very difficult gym to leave the game early at.
That's for sure.
So
you're involved in a game if you try to leave early.
Yeah, right.
Kalixte can't hit the shot. Off the rim, no good. McManus out to Curtis Anderson. 69-47, a 22-point advantage as Curtis Anderson throws it up, no good. Whitten with another rebound. Scooney Penn out in front. Lays it in. Scooney's got 18. And the lead is 24. Chris Puska, picked off by Scooney Penn. Penn throws it in. Yeah. People are amazed. Chris Puska is a story, 25. He's a basketball player and a good one. He's going to be a good one. The Puska family have been noted as hockey players. Brother, of course, older brother was a goalie at English and Holy Cross. As Penn throws in a three.
And he might
might get his 27 done.
Well, he's got 23.
Yeah.
And of course, his other brother Andy was an excellent scorer at English. He went on to, I forget which academy went to playing hockey now, but he's a good one. And people said, Apostko playing basketball? It's a model sin. But he's going to be a good one.
And I just wonder, this time of the game with 5:20 left, with Salem up by almost 30 points, when Garrity's going to take Penn and Witten out of the ballgame.
Blocked by Penn, saved LaMontagne. Go, nice spin move and lays it in. And they're trapping and pressing besides. Penn. Ben Kalicz, big block by Curtis Anderson.
Yeah, he got up there high that time.
LaMontagne can't throw it in. Curtis Anderson with the basketball. Pass off. Jesus Marquez. The game, Donovan Billings in for it. Tyson Witten.
So Witten comes out, Penn stays, 4:39, 31-point lead. I take exception to that. I
like Salem. I enjoy watching Salem. I don't want to see Scooney Penn out there at this time of the game.
No, you certainly, and you,
absolutely
and
not.
You certainly wouldn't want to see Scooney Penn get hurt in a situation like this. Throws it up and in for two. Trying to give him his 27. Tommy Giotti will pick up the foul, and Walter White is looked like he came down a little gingerly on that ankle. Hopefully he's all right.
He'll be all right long enough to shoot his free throws, John.
Walter had just a terrific year for the football team of English, and they're looking for big things for him next year. He played just terrific.
Oh, he's a fine athlete.
He went in as a replacement on defense, and they couldn't. Coach Gary Malik couldn't get him out of the lineup.
It's always a nice thing to happen.
That's for sure. Nice to know you got him coming back next year, too. Walter a little too strong with the first one. Walter White misses it. Donovan Billings with the rebound. This is Ben Kalicki. One more team to Scooney Penn. For three, no good. Picked off by Scooney Penn. Can't hit the shot, but he gets hit. They'll go to the free throw line. And we've got Eric Smith getting set. He's going to come in this soon for Scooney Penn.
Yeah, after Coach Garrity. So it's going to get knocked to the floor on that one. I think he said, okay, 4 minutes ago, the ball game's over. Let's get the franchise out.
Well, if it means anything, if he makes these two join, he'll get his 27. I'm not sure it means anything.
No, absolutely not. What means something is having a healthy whole team ready to get into the tournament when it's tournament time in a couple of weeks.
I don't think Scooney wanted to come out. He missed a foul shot.
Wow.
Carrero gets fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line. So now, Eric Smith is going to come in the ball game replacing Scooney Penn.
I think Coach Garrity's going to let us enjoy it a little more, and he calls a timeout here with 3:55 to go.
3:55 left, a 34-point lead for the Witches.
What do you think we're talking about here in this huddle, John, over there?
Where do you want to go for pizza? Or?
Yeah, really. Well, we know where they want to go for pizza. But,
I'm not sure how much you have to worry about or what you have to teach these guys right now.
Yeah. Anyways, looking forward, looking ahead. Tuesday night, John. Swampscott Salem.
Going to be a real good ball game.
I have a lot of respect for Brian Bagley. I thought he did a very nice gesture. He said on the radio broadcast, I heard him on. He said, we're taking it as a championship game. We want to win it on the floor, and we're coming there as though both teams are one loss, and we're going to play it that way.
Absolutely. You see, I think it works. It works against Swampscott.
I think it does too. Yeah.
I think it distracts them because
I think it's a letdown because all of a sudden, guess what? They're going to be the Northeastern Conference champs, period.
And they already know that.
You know, everybody knows that. That's what's going to happen. So not that they don't want to win the game, not that they don't want to play hard in the game, but it takes a little of the edge off. Whereas Salem's going to go in there and say, hey, you know, we want to be able to 15 years from now say that we beat the team twice that won the Northeastern Conference that year. So, you know, they're going to have a big impetus to play hard. Not that they need anything more.
Walked away with the layup, a great pass from Chris Poska, and double dribble by Kalixti, and the turnover. 81-49. The Salem Witches well in hand. This is Jesus Marquez going against Eric Smith. Chris Poska with the basketball. McManus and Poska. Poska looks to drive. Nice pass to Walter White in the lane. The hook shot is good.
Nice pass. That worked.
So Poska and Walter White combine again.
Sure, you got the penetration from Poska and White went to the basket. That's how it's supposed to work. Ooh, got a reach, yeah.
McManus is going to pick up the foul.
Yeah. Again, he had him far enough away from the basket where he didn't have to do that, John. You know, young guys should learn that, you know, the idea is to keep him far enough from the basket so he can't turn around and make the easy one. And as long as you've done that, you've done your job. Then let him catch the ball.
And then
work on not moving.
Wow. Eric Smith looked like he was going to break to the basket, and he got the pass right back, not expecting it, and went by him out of bounds.
It's the old wide receiver that takes his eye off the ball.
Speaking of that, this game will be on before the Super Bowl, so what is your pick?
What's my pick? Dallas, John. Yeah. The better team always wins.
Okay. Well, just so we got that on record.
Okay.
Jesus Marquez with the basket. This is Kalixti outside.
Hopefully it's a better game than, or a closer score than this one, but.
LaMontagne with a nice shot. He's got a nice touch.
Yeah, real nice touch.
Squares up nice, throws the shot up nice. Ooh. Goes for the steal, doesn't get it. Guerrero, the whirling dervish.
Oh, nice pass.
The foul is against Giannis, and he's on the floor. Again, it was Poska going to Walter White. 42. Every time he sees him go down, Kenny Perrone has probably a little another gray hair pop up. He's the quarterback for next year. Was the quarterback this year. He was with some young kids. I mean, excuse me, Salem we've talked about. With some young kids out there now. Kalixti is back. Tommy Giardi is back. Also, of course, Scooney Penn coming back. So
who?
Still,
who was that? I thought you were going to forget him, John. I wasn't going to help you either.
James Penn, so nobody would know who he was.
Yeah, really. Oh, that's a carry. But at this point of the ball game, it doesn't matter.
Let's put this in. Run the clock.
Nice defense.
Good job by Walter White. Throws it up.
What the heck?
I might as well throw it in.
Guess what? I'm open.
I can't do anything else. I'll throw in the basket.
A travel. Yeah.
Smith got caught betwixt and between.
Yeah. Did the old hop with the pivot foot that time.
83.
At least English will keep him out of the century mark.
83-56 as Poska throws it up again.
And he gets manhandled.
they call an English ball out of bounds.
Well, of course. The foul was there, but they're not going to call it. But they will give it back to him.
Inside to McManus. Can't get it to fall, but he'll go to the free throw line. 1:33 left. Comfortably ahead is Salem, leading by 27. And I'll beat you to the punch. Salem is going to win their first game of the year.
I wouldn't have said that. Because I've seen them win other games this year. But I know what you're saying. But again, as we said before the game even started, you know, with the tournament situation as it is, where everybody gets in, you know, it's
I talked to some.
Other than the fact that they don't have the opportunity to win the conference, which certainly is a big deal, but it's
absolutely.
You know, it's not the end of the world. These kids still have a chance to win a championship.
Foul's going to be against Donovan Billings.
And it's funny, I talked to a lot of the Sale people. And their initial reaction was, I hate the open tournament. There's going to be some, and I do, especially I do too, but I think you're going to have some kind of carrot. Most of the Sale people are saying, no, I was against it, but now I don't think it's too bad.
Well, you know, it's funny because you look at this open tournament. I'm one person who doesn't like the open tournament format because I think it de-emphasizes the season. But the, you know, this is one case that you don't even really ever think about, you know. And now you have a real reason why maybe you do have it.
Yeah, I agree.
But I still don't like it, and I would never vote for it.
No, I would not vote for it either.
Curtis Anderson would replace Walter White with 122 left. Donovan Billings at the line.
If we could get a point for Eric Smith, we would have everybody on both sides who have played scored.
Okay. Well, let's do it, John. Pass him the ball.
I think we should tell him that.
Yeah.
And leave Eric Smith at one end of the floor. Just throw it down. Or what we used to do in the park league.
Yeah. We used to do a lot of things in the park league.
Donovan can't get the shot to fall. Curtis Anderson, let's go with the three.
It's good, nothing but net.
Ben Calixte to LaMontagne, strong drive. Not gonna go, but he's gonna go to the free throw line.
The foul is on Mike McManus. Four fouls on Mike McManus.
And not in a lot of time, John.
That's for sure.
He really hasn't played a lot of minutes.
Brian, a little bit too strong.
I think that's one of the problems he had earlier when we saw him, too. He was picking up a lot of fouls, John. And, you know, that'll come with a little maturity and a little age. He's just going to have to not give up the little cheap little fouls. That's a strong move right there.
Donovan Billings throws it in. Guerrero. Ben Calixte. Donovan Billings had a hand on the ball, and I thought he thought the foul was automatically on him. Now, Sale, Tony Mataragas is going to come in the game. They only have 10 players, so a follow with 49 seconds left, 86-60. Mario Carrero hits one. Here, a couple of big baskets and foul shots this year to win a couple of games for us. Mataragas bringing the ball up floor.
Well, they want him to get the ball.
Eric Smith can't hit the shot.
You think they don't know that he's the only one that hasn't scored yet?
Busca loses it, gets it back. Picked off.
Oh.
Almost picked off by Smith for a layup and a foul. Now they
dribble
it
out of bounds.
Yeah, he dribbled out of bounds.
28 seconds. I wonder who they're going to set up, John.
I know who Tony tried to set up.
Yeah, I do,
Let's
too.
Let's see if they do it again. LaMontagne can't hit it.
Nice
to
play.
Smith. Can't get the shot. Guerrero.
Nice pass.
To McManus. Nice play. LaMontagne. Billings from deep in the corner. Smith got the rebound, but time runs out. 86 to 64, and we talked about the big first half they had, Joan, with 40 points after starting slow. They come out and they bang in 46 more in the second half.
46 more with the starters on the bench with 4 minutes to go.
Yeah,
and they're just a tremendous offensive team. I mean, tremendous team. Play great defense and everything else.
The big win by Salem, start their second season. They're now kind of three seasons. The first 14 games, the last six games, and then the state tournament. But I think they put away any doubts that anybody thought that they would not be ready to play the last six games after what they've gone through the last couple of days. And
they were just a fine team. And they just fight their way through the adversity, and that leads to being a great team.
So they win the game 86-64, a big 22-point win. Scoonie Penn with 26. Tyson Wood had a mammoth game with 24. And Tony Mataragas chips in with 14. Juancio Hernandez had 7 and an awful lot of rebounds. For on the other side of the ledger, Quam Rocker had 18, and Jesus Escalera had 10. But everybody on the side in the game for English got at least 1 point and get on the scoreboard. But they just couldn't put up with that defensive pressure that Salem put on. And it just it was devastating at times, just taking the ball away. They kept themselves stuck in corners, and it was just the defensive really put them away.
Absolutely, John. When you can go into your opposition's gym, which is normally a tough gym to play in, and you can beat them by, 22 points, in a walk. It just tells you how good you are. And you just got to play a super ball game to beat them. And it just wasn't going to happen tonight.
Yeah, Scoonie Penn was, slow getting out of the blocks, but Tyson Witten kept him close, and then Scoonie put it into second gear, and Tony Mataragas had a big second half with 8, and they win in the walk, 86-64. So Salem goes 1-14. English goes 8-6. And we'll look for the big one on Tuesday night against Swampscott. So stay tuned for more sports coming up here on TV3 Sports Sunday.